jacked for wearing.
Hey there, folks, it's Josh, and you're watching That Christian Show, and it is Wednesday, I believe, the 7th. Yes, it is, at 9:40 p.m., and Maggie Dresser had her hip surgery today, the replacement surgery, and she's been long since come out of surgery, and survived that, and all that, and I just want to encourage people watching this to pray for Maggie if you haven't already, and even if you have, continue praying for her that she would make a speedy recovery and be back to her normal good self as soon as possible with a brand new hip so she can climb apple trees and do all sorts of fun stuff that she's really into. So, yeah, there's that. And then there's, you're watching yet another webisode of That Christian Show. Where I read from what people I'm friends with or ministries that I'm a fan of on Facebook, whenever they do or say anything that's, you know, generally of a good Christian nature. There's that. And also I read some stuff from my prayer journal until I get a repeat, because it's an app on my iPhone. And I read them on random, and sometimes you get a repeat, and when I get a repeat, I stop. So, yeah, try not to guess too much about where I'm at right now. Basically, I got banished here because they fed me all sorts of stuff that gives me wicked... Hang on. Wicked gas. And so I got banished to the bathroom until such time as I can come out. And be a part of society again. So, yeah, pray that that works out for me, too. Oh, and pray that me and Kristen can get the finances together to get an apartment or whatever. Not that we want to leave Misfit Acres too much. We really don't. But she needs to get back to work. She really wants to get back to work. And she really likes to work in the human services area. Field as a group home manager or a caseworker for mentally challenged adults and teenagers and stuff. And she's gotten no hits whatsoever in Vermont and New Hampshire. If you want to pray that she gets a job in that field in Vermont, that would be awesome. Otherwise, pray that the people or the companies that are reaching out to her and offering her a job in Maine can somehow swing an open door for us to get a place to live out there, too. Because it's a two-hour commute, and not that I mind, but because I'll probably be, you know, filming stuff and enjoying the ride back and forth, but, you know, it is a gas expense that we can't really afford right now. It'd be better to put that money into a place to live. So, yeah, there you go. And if you have a prayer request, leave it in the comment section below or leave a video response. So, reading. Or over the past. Oh, yeah. See, it's 9:53, and we're at 2. See, it's 9:53, and we're at 2. Hey there, folks. Today is August 31st, 2010, and I thought maybe I would read to you some stuff from the Christian feeds that I have on Facebook, and here we go. No, there's nobody home. From Yehoshua Caleb Saddam, who used to be Joshua Caleb Saddam, if people let the government decide what foods they eat, their bodies will soon be in as sorry a state as are the souls of those who live under tyranny. Thomas Jefferson. God understands our prayers even when we can't find the words to say them. Press like if you agree. I do. Be on your guard, stand firm in the faith, be men of courage, be strong. 1 Corinthians 16:13. Soldier guards the tomb of the unknown soldier during Hurricane Irene. Despite Hurricane Irene happening around him, a lone tomb sentinel guards the tomb in Arlington National Cemetery. The tomb has been guarded every second of every day since April 6, 1948. Watch this powerful video. Well, I'm not going to show you the powerful video. I believe in God. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land. 2 Chronicles 7:14. What is your prayer for today? Leave it in the comments or put a response video up if you want. The Bible. Zephaniah 3:17. The Lord your God is with you. His power gives you victory. The Lord will take delight in you, and in his love, he will give you new life. He will sing and be joyful over you. I believe in God. God ordained us not to... Hey there. So, either I'm in a forest that has... What's up, people? Here I'm going to read to you some prayer requests from the prayer journal that I keep on my iPhone until I get a repeat. For me, can I get permission to fast? His and her secrets, what's good? Elizabeth Dresser, what's good? Mitchell Dresser, that he wouldn't be a stranger to his friends. Me, I pray that I could quit smoking. Does that mean no more cigarettes today? Well, if God gives me the strength not to have another one today, then I don't have to have another one today. For Dennis Leary, what's good? For Bob Tripaldi, what's good? For Naomi McKinnon, what's good? For Matthew Dresser, Matt possesses the mystic secret of the faith, Christian truth as hidden from ungodly men with a clear conscience, 1 Timothy 3:9. For Jessica Salemi, what's good? For me, I will follow my lose-it plan today. Ooh. Uh-oh. Means I gotta put in what I ate for breakfast. Dang it. For Richard of... Chichester. Oh, it's a prayer from Richard of Chichester. Thanks be to thee, my Lord Jesus Christ, for all the benefits thou hast won for me, for all the pains and insults thou hast borne for me. O most merciful Redeemer, friend and brother, may I know thee more clearly, love thee more dearly, and follow thee more nearly, forever and ever.
Want a cigarette, sweetie?
No.
Not much. Oh, I didn't realize you were videotaping. Here.
Come in and put your face next to mine. Look at your nose.
That was a cute picture without all the squiggly noses.
Yeah. It's mixing our cheeks together now. Why is your face so much smaller than mine?
Got a cute little girl's face. And you have a big manly face.
Yeah.